Web scraping is a very tedious task for most website owners and developers. Today, let's learn how to use UiPath in extracting information from a website. Let's take eBay for example. What I have on my screen is a filtered search result in Amazon's Kindle. So, what we're going to do is to create an automation that will extract the titles, links, and prices of the items and save it in a CSV file through a spreadsheet. Let's get started. From the design menu, let's click on Web Scraping. This will open a web scraping wizard. This will give us a step-by-step and easy-to-follow guide on what to scrape. Let's click Next to indicate the item we want to scrape. The recording tool is now active. What the UiPath does is it will scrape the data using a pattern of two elements in the same category. It's a faster way to validate collection of data by comparing both selected items. In this example, I will click the first title. The wizard will ask for the second element on a page to validate the selection. So we will click the second item on the list. You will notice that the items you want to scrape are highlighted. This gives you a preview of the items to be extracted. Once you're done selecting two items in the same pattern, the web scraping wizard will provide these information. Extract text, which is currently checked as default, will extract the actual title of the item. Extract URL gives you an option to extract the URL of the item. The column name will appear on top of each column. Let's give it a proper name, let's say product name. Let's enable the URL and give it a name as well. Let's click Next. As you can see, it gives you a preview of the extracted data. Let's add a price in another column. To add another item in this collection, we can use Extract Correlated Data button. Let's click on it. The process will be the same. We will select two items of our target data. But remember, the first item we selected for the product name during the recording is the first and the second titles in the result page. So, if we want to scrape the price, we should pattern it with the previous selection. Let's click Next and click on the price of the first item. Let's click Next and click the price of the second item. Let's put in price as the column name. We don't need the URL for this one, so let's leave it blank. Let's click Finish. The wizard will proceed to this question. This will give you an option to extract the data if it spans to multiple pages. This page has 180 results and it is currently sorted 25 per page. That means the items of our search results span to multiple pages. Let's scroll down so we can see the next button. Let's click Yes so we can indicate the next button. Okay, let's click on the next button. That's it, we're done. Our workflow is ready, let's review it. Here's the UiPath activity, extract structured data, that handles all of it. The output of this activity is stored in a data table format, which sends it to write CSV file activity that produces the extracted data in a CSV file. In the input section, we have an option to limit the number of results. It's currently set to 100. You can set it to unlimited or until all the data has been extracted by putting 0 as a value. Alright, are you ready to find out the result? Let's run the workflow. As you can see, it moves from one page to another as it captures data in each page. It's done! The default location of the CSV file is where the workflow is saved. Here's an easy way to locate it. Go to the Workspace panel. Here, you can see your workflow file. Right-click on it and select Open Containing Folder. Here's the CSV file. Let's open it. Perfect! There's our data. Let's check how many items have been extracted. It's a total of 100 plus 1 for the header names. Let's run the web scraping using another type web page format. We will extract data from Google Contacts. Let's open UiPath and scrape data in this page. Let's go to the Design tab and click Web Scraping. This will pull up the wizard. Let's click Next. Let's click the name of the first row. UiPath automatically detects that this page is in HTML table format. It will give you this message if you want to extract the data from the whole table. Let's click Yes. This will display the extracted data. Let's set the number to 0, so it will extract all data in this page. We're done! Let's click Finish. This dialog will ask if data spans in multiple pages. Since this is just a single page, let's just click No for this one. We're done! Let's set this as start node. Let's run it. That's it. It's done. Let's check the result. Let's check the last item in the spreadsheet, and let's compare it with the page we scraped. It works perfect. You just learned how to use UiPath to easily extract tabular and pattern-based data across multiple web pages. The UiPath web scraping tool is so flexible and easy to use. Now you have a solution of extracting larger variety of data in any format from the web. Thanks again for watching. Till then.